Crusader Kings 2. This is the Wolf's Revenge, and this is the series finale, the last episode of our great King Eddard, the Bold of the North. He's had a very interesting and exciting journey. For a series that I thought would only last for maybe two, three episodes, I thought Eddard was actually going to die in the first episode. That we've survived 13, I think, is pretty darn good. Now, you're probably wondering, Joe, what could we possibly do with this series in the final episode? And we actually have a couple things we can do to finally finish this all out with hopefully a better ending than the fucking actual show for Game of Thrones. No more super dark Battle of Winterfell, can't see shit, plot armor for everybody. No more subverting expectations in an extremely amateur and inept way. No, we're going to do stuff that actually makes sense. And a lot of it is going to be based off of what you guys suggested in the last episode. Actually, I need to slow this down a little bit. Now, unfortunately, we don't have the greatest treasury. Okay, sowing dissent between Commander Humphrey of the Dragon Gate and his king and his liege, King Aemon. Right. So one thing somebody suggested that we should do, that I wholeheartedly agree with, is the demand of the return of certain artifacts to the Kingdom of the North. The North. God, I can't believe I almost forgot. An artifact that is justly property of House Stark is currently in the Iron Throne. A demand can be sent for its return under the threat of war. War! A message is sent. Let's see. Crown of Winter currently held by King Aemon Baratheon. Oh, yeah. We can't be a real king without the Crown of Winter. Which we somehow have on our head. but not in our inventory. Rob has ice. Brilliant. Now, here's the thing. There are two things we can do. We can demand the return of artifacts, or we can take the Reach for Marjorie Tyrell. Actually, no, we'd be a truce breaker, which would make all Westerosi gods' rulers' opinion of us minus 25. We could claim King's Landing. Could we claim the Reach? We could. Oh, this is going to be hard. Our allies would be the Iron Throne, so we could either win the Reach from Marjorie Tyrell, in which case we'd be fucking unstoppable, or we could demand the return of the Crown of Winter. Now, we have 35,000 men. The Greyjoys are weak. They have 12,000 men. The Vale, it actually kind of likes King Aemon, Warden of the East, Advisor. So they have 21,000 men. Yeah, King Aemon, he actually is doing really, really well for himself. He has 64,000 men. That's a lot more men than we have. Would Wireless come around for us this time? I don't know. If he does, we win. If he does, we win. And I really do think that Lord Paramount, Wireless the Hunter, form an alliance. We can't because he's currently the liege of, we could. I kind of want to get the Crown of Winter. Maybe King Aemon will actually capitulate and give us the crown. Maybe. He holds two Crowns of Winter. We will demand them both. And when he refuses to hand them over, we will declare a final war against King Aemon. We might lose because it's going to make us a truce breaker. But God damn it, if this is going to be the end of the series, we need to do it right. Which, I don't even know if this is the right thing to do. To the old jester King Eddard, we will not cave in to these naked threats. The artifact which you say to claim will remain in the Iron Throne, signed King Aemon Baratheon. Remember guys, this is the son of the tyrant King Renly of the Empty Pockets, who was shockingly slain by the rogue Kingsguard Rickard Fell. Fine, call the banners. I know we have a truce, and this might actually be our undoing. But you know what? We're going to go out with a bang, and we're going to launch the war for the Iron Throne, has declared King Eddard's war to reclaim their ancestral heirloom from King Aemon. Okay. What's going on? Lord Commander Loras of the Kingsguard has joined King Aemon. Lord Paramount Herald of the Vale has joined him. How many people have joined him? We're attacking him. The Vale is on his side. Lord Commander Loras of the Kingsguard is on his side. So we're fighting the Vale. That's not great. Zealous. What is this plus 15? Marriage ties. Oh, yeah. Form an alliance, you son of a bitch. No, you didn't. Could we give him something to make him like us? Could we give him the engines of war? Could we give him a weirwood bow? Ooh, personal combat skill plus 15. Maybe that's what we need to do. Give him an artifact, and that'll make him love us. Offer engines of war as a gift to Lord Paramount Wyless the Hunter. Or a weirwood bow. Ooh, plus 48. Because I don't really see... I don't see Lord Paramount Eddard actually doing any fighting. I don't think we're going to have him command any armies. We probably should have fixed our commanders, but you know what? We really need Wyless on our side. So we'll give him the weirwood bow. We can always make another one. And we need to call in our allies. And we need to forbid ourselves from command. And we need to give ourselves... Only the best... The best commanders, and that is definitely... Oh, are you kidding? Where's Ramsay? Did he die? Maybe. Maybe he did. Let's see. Ramsay, Bolton, the Mad, died clutching at his heart. Damn it. Yeah. I wanted to kind of have that meme, you know, only the best people, Ramsay Bolton. All right. Well, anyways, we need to get better commanders. Let's see if we can invite any. Only the best. Sir Harold Nestorin, not in prison. Invite to court. Richard. Now, did we actually get Alliance Breaker? Did we actually get Alliance Breaker? Rallying support. I don't know. We might not actually have... I don't think we actually got Alliance Breaker. Medium Realm Authority desires the kingdom of... Oh yeah, Patrick Malister wants the Trident. I don't know. I don't think we got the Alliance Breaker thing. Did we somehow circumvent it by demanding the return of artifacts? I mean, he really likes us too. Jesus. Could we get the Westerlanders on our side? I don't know. Let's not declare war on them. This is going to be kind of cheesy, but I mean, do we have any children that we could arrange to marriage them? I don't think so. Probably not. Jaime Lannister. I know they're not technically supposed to be friends, but he's got kids, right? Lord Emery. Can anybody marry him? That's a Stark? No, of course not. Shit, that's not going to work. Let's try swaying him. Or you know what? We could also give him an artifact. We can give him the engines of war if we want to, and he'll accept. Do it! If we can get the Westerlands and the Reach on our side to help us get the crowns of... You would dare have Lady Tyta Tully killed. She's remaining independent. How dare she? How dare she? All right. Marshal the men. Marshal the men. Yeah, it's going to take some time to get all of our troops together, huh? All right. Actually, you know what? Bring them all to Moat Cailin. It seems to be the best place to amass the northern armies first. Actually, going to have you guys march back here, too. And I'm actually going to have all of these forces march back to the Twins. Because we don't know what type of fighting is going to occur, so let's get them back to the Twins, and we'll get these armies to Moat Cailin. We will marshal our forces together. We will keep ourselves from command. Let's see, Lyle Crakehall, have we invited you? Let's go ahead and invite you. Let's just get all the guys who have got 20. Metallurgist, nice. Let the war begin. Lord Horace has joined. Lady Delena, I mean. Of course, I will honor my obligation, so the Greyjoys are with us. Allies. So now it is, let's see, it is the Iron Isles versus the Iron Throne and the Vale. How many troops do they have now that they've split? 38,000. Okay, so we can almost match him. We cannot match the forces of the Vale. Is this despicable scum. Executed realm subject. I don't remember doing that. I didn't do that, you liar. He's a liar. Jaime Lannister has had the engines of war added to their treasury. All right. To the level-headed, I will, of course, accept your gift. Too bad I can't have you join us in the war. He might, though. He might join us. We don't really know yet. All right, he's considering taking a gift from Lord Stark. King Stark, I should say. Accept your gracious invitation. Why is, this taking so long to get to Wyless. I accept your gracious gift. What a splendid object. Form an alliance. He might come through in the end. I'm kind of hoping the Westerlands and the Reach decide to help us. They may not. They may not, but if they don't, I request the right to take the black, Sir Otto Viril. Viril, well, no, I don't believe so. You will be fighting in our armies. You can join the watch later. All right, just go ahead and switch all these people out that suck with awesome commanders. That seems to be it for now. I thought we invited like 5 people. All right, we just have to be super smart about this war. If we can be super smart about this war, we can win. We can win. How many men are protecting King Aemon? 5,000. Okay. Could we plot to kidnap him? We could try, but it probably wouldn't work. Let's see. We've got rulership right now, huh? Sansa is in hiding. Okay, because she's giving birth to her 6th child. Jesus Christ. Oh, man. They have been busy. That's what I like to see. Okay. Looks fine right now. Looks fine right now. I think inviting Lord Paramount Jaime to an activity we can both do together will help us grow closer. Let's see. We're 57. He is 54. Oh, we're so, okay. Upcoming local fencing tournament. Well, we're both duelists, right? We're both duelists, so why not? 50-year-old duelists. That's what we'll do. So we just need to get the AI to be really stupid. Ah, Lord Paramount Jaime looks excited as the first rounds of the tournament starts. I brandish my blade and am ready as well. We'll take the win for sure. No one will stop the King of the North and the Kingslayer. Unless he chooses to kill us in this tournament for some reason, which would be, I don't know, that'd be interesting. It'd be kind of silly. We passed through all the preliminary rounds, little no issue. In the last round, we were facing 2 large, ogre-looking men. The swords tiny in their hands. The larger they are, the harder they fall. I decided to go on the offense. A higher chance of getting wounded, but also a higher chance of success if Lord Paramount Jaime goes on the offense as well. I will tire them out. I wait for them to tire out. A lower chance of getting wounded, but also a lower chance... No. We will go on the offensive. We will be badass. Along with the Kingslayer. Ooh, your acquaintance Jeremy Lannister died a stillborn. Interesting. What is Dorne doing? Dorne is doing, fuck all. They're doing none. Though the 2 lumbering men fought for their lives, they finally gave up. They finally give up and fall to the ground exhausted. I look over at Jaime and cheer. The fight is more than I could have hoped for. Alright, we've got our first men who have entered the Riverlands. And we have Valemen as well. Alright, this forward army of 10,000 men at the Twins. Let's give them the best command as we can. We don't have anyone who can lead the fucking center, do we? Shit. Find me people who are good in the center, dammit. We got flankers. Owen will take you, Sir Owen. Roland. Roland Storm. Sir Roland Storm of Slat Bridge. We need you, sir. Any more flankers? Ah, yes, we'll take Asher Forrester. I thought we already had him. Sir Prester Rampton. That's how we will win. We will have the best commanders. There we go. Swang Jaime Lannister to try to get him to goddamn join us. All right, I don't care about these trials of combat. All right, we got more people invited. More people invited. Excellent. Now then, let's fix our commanders one more time. Get this army of 10,000 ready to go. Lord Small John, Lord Morgan of Bear Isle. We'll get Roland. All right. Who is our center command? That is Roland. And then we will get our flankers. Our best flankers on the side. Owen and the Small John. March down here. Destroy the Valemen. And while they're doing that, we will bring the rest of our forces. The rest of our... Oh my... Holy shit. Okay. AI is doing the typical attack the north in 2 spots. How will that work out? How do we stop that? How do we stop that? Let's see how many men they have. They've got 6,000. We would need almost 10,000 to march back north and destroy these forces here. If we do, it'll work out in our favor. Is there anyone here who's got 10K? Okay, merge the units and split them in half. I want 10,000 led by Rob and Rickon. And someone else who's good. How about Otto? You guys will march north, and you will retake Pine's End. That's what they're going to do, too. They're going to try and take the areas that have got the mountainous terrain, because it's a lot harder to take it back. To the Heroic King Eddard, I accept your invitation. As Lord Paramount Jaime's about to leave, he thanks me for the invitation to the tournament. It seems my plan has worked out. That's good to know. That's good to know. How does he feel about his liege? Explore character options. Find characters. That's not really what I wanted to happen. Okay, never mind. All right, we gotta be careful. I think the armies of the Iron Throne are just gonna chill here. Do you? Ooh, it's warming as it comes. Okay. War is coming to. Winter is coming to an end. Okay. Vale forces are here. Maybe chill there. The Vale is coming out. The Iron Throne seems to be just relaxing. All right. We have got one group of 2,000 men that it has to arrive in Mokaelin. There we go. Now march down here to the Freylands. No, to Arryn-Ford, and then we will crush the Vale men in open combat. Open combat. And we so far have no allies yet. Wireless will not join us. Oh, his poor wife has the pox. Poor thing. Form an alliance, you son of... He has now changed his mind. Ladies and gentlemen, we may be... I am fuzzy as all hell. I cannot get my green screen to work today. It's being all sorts of problem. All sorts of problems. But with this alliance, we can call the Reach into the war. And they will bring along with them another 36,000 men. Yes. Call them into the war. Can we form an alliance with you? Damn it, we can't. Is there no one in our goddamn family? All right, hold on. Let's be a little bit more diligent about this. Find me Edara Marna. Oh God, you married her to a Glover. Damn you. And you have married to a Malister and Reynard. How do we marry you? How about we do it this way? Find me a Lannister. Peony. Lannister. Do it. How is she related? Oh, she's related to Sir Lancel Kubek. Okay, of Kubek Hall. Kubek is down here, right? Bram Hope. How is that related to... Oh, Jesus. You're not related at all. Oh, shit. Well, we'll see if that works, but I doubt it will. Let's see. You have Lord Daemon, who is 13. We have Princess Mara, who is 1. Ooh, that might... Actually, that probably won't work. Wait a minute. How old is Emery? He's 3. So if we take Mara, our granddaughter, we arrange a betrothal. No. Do it this way. And we find a Lannister. We have Daemon. I don't think they're going to agree to that. They're agreeing to that. Oh, this could be it, ladies and gentlemen. If this works, if Jaime Lannister agrees, of course I'll honor my obligation and call to war. Yes. Let loose the dogs of war. Now we just need Jaime Lannister. Is he currently accepting a proposition? I don't know. The alliance and non-aggression pact between Rickon, Kerwin, and I'll just have to smooth this over. I need to know, is he going to accept? Is warming as winter comes to an end in Winterfell? Great. This army is still coming down here. This army is marching up here to destroy these forces. We have soldiers trying to besiege Winterfell. Or are they just traveling through Winterfell? They're just traveling through Winterfell. So they are going to accept that marriage proposal? Maybe. Yes? No? Doesn't matter. We have the Reach on our side. All right, I'm getting kind of concerned. Where is that proposal? Mara, Lady Mara, betrothed to Lord Daemon. Can we not form an alliance now? Is it close relative or has a non-aggression pact? Oh, we need a non-aggression pact. Damn you! Sir Jaime. Lord Paramount Jaime, apologies. Let's give him some gold. We can afford it. Surely now he'll agree. Damn you! We need you to give us this non-aggression pact. You son of a bitch. King Eddard the Bold has inherited the lordship of Mokaelin and other titles from Lord Stark. Dear King Eddard of the North, I hereby invite you to the wedding of Prince Eddard Stark and Maria Malister. I will travel to the wedding. Yes, I will. And Mokaelin has fallen back into our command, and Robb Stark is now with us. My courtier, Sir Lau Craigall, has expressed a desire to get married. Married as you please, sir. Please. All right, and we've got our 23,000 men. We have the Vale traveling back. The Vale armies are traveling back, so let's retake the Salt Pans. And then maybe we can go down south and destroy the forces of the Iron Throne. Where the fuck is Theon? He's over here fighting his own little wars, is he? Oh, yeah. Ironborn Civil War for elective monarchy. So he's a little busy. He's a little tied up at the moment. Man, if we can just get... Oh, shit. Lady Catelyn is dead, and she was murdered under suspicious circumstances. She was dishonorable. She was dishonorable. I cannot believe it. Dearest Catelyn, my hero lady, you are gone from this world and left behind, alone and heartbroken. I will never hold you in my arms again. I do not know what to do with these unbearable feelings. I will seek solace at your grave. That's always a good idea. And now we are widowed. Actually, we're not widowed. We can actually marry. We can actually marry. It's kind of weird. Thanks to the gods' great mercy, there were no other visitors, and I've got a lover's memento. So Jaime Lannister really, really, really likes us, but he will not. He will not accept a non-aggression pact. Who else could we appeal to? There is Dorne. There is Dorne. Arrange a marriage between. Let's see. There are no Martells apparently. No Martells. No female Martells, that is. Okay, so they're kind of out of the question here. Volantis has 2,000 men. Tyrosh has 9,000. Pentos has 8,000. Mir has 12,000. Ooh. How many does Lyse have? 12,000 as well. Nice. Okay, how about Braavos? Surely they have lots of people. 21,000. Yes, we have a winner. Can we marry anybody from... What house is this? Fhraegar. We need to marry somebody to the King Eddard. Tell me you have a Fhraegar here. You do not. Do you have a young... No, you don't. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Let's see. Gilar Fhraegar. No, we can't. They have no one. Could we marry somebody to you? Trent? No. How about a betrothal? No. Shit. Damn it, we need allies. We need more allies if we're going to win this war. Pentos has 8,000 men. Mir has more, right? You have 12. Surely you have someone who can marry King Eddard. No, you don't, apparently. Wow, assholes. How about you, Pirate King Salador? Nope, he doesn't have 8,000. Should we marry a relative of a pirate lord? Let's try it. Nope, there are none. Lyseni, they're of House San. Yeah, it's House San, all right. Arrange a betrothal between Eddard and Malera San Lyseni. This would give us a non-aggression pact. Maybe we can do better than that. Maybe we can marry an actual Lannister who's related to... I mean, this would result in a non-aggression pact. This would force Jaime Lannister's hand. I don't really want an old wife, though. I mean, Tyta. Ooh, Tyta. She's beautiful and attractive. But that wouldn't result in a non-aggression pact. If we marry Tyshera, she's 66, and then there's Sorella, who's... But that would give us a non-aggression pact. And, I mean, we don't really need any more children. No. Political concerns. You bastard, Jaime. Damn you. Fine, whatever. We will win this without you then. Prince Rob greeted us warmly at the wedding. And that wasted a lot of time diddling away with that. Now, Mary and Malast. Yeah. Malasters and Starks are getting married. Good for them. The wedding is winding down. Woohoo. Let's just do a. Let's retake Salt Pans. And we will take a King's Landing rush. This force here, Rob. My son Rob. Where do you go? Where do you go? We got a Prince Rickon. No, we need Rickon. Who do we not need? The Strongbore, Sir Harold Nestorin, Sir Prester, Sir Owen. The Small John. Let's replace the Small John with Rob. I want Rob. Where is Rob? There he is. Retake this. And then who's leading this army now down here? Okay, Harold, Owen, and Lyle. Okay, Siege of Fermont. Salt Pans hold fast. Retake it. The feast is winding down, and they do the bedding. Of course. Go ahead and retake that shit there, and retake that. So we've retaken all of Salt Pans. And apparently we are on the offensive now. Battle of Harclay. Let's march for King's Landing. We should probably attack from the south. No, you know what? Okay, here's the thing. If we attack them here, they'll reinforce. And I think from King's Landing to Rosby, there's a river? Yes, so they'd have to cross a river to reinforce at Rosby. So let's go to Edgerton. All right, we've got Harold. No, Harold, you're not supposed to be there. It's supposed to be Roland. Owen's on the flank because he's got flanker, and then Lyle actually needs to be a flanker as well. Prester. Good. A proper army. And then we got this force here. Ah. They'll have the advantage of the mountains. But we will take them. Rob will lead us to great victory. Prince Rob's wedding's over. Great. Good for him. King Eddard has inherited lordship of Crow's something. Testimony of mushrooms. Okay. We no longer have a hand of the king, and it looks like Rob may be fat. Rob has gotten fat. No, he hasn't. He just looks like he has. We need a new hand of the king. New hand of the king shall be... Benjicott. High Almoner will be Rob, Keeper of the Swans. Just give it to whoever. Whoever. We need proper bodyguards. Proper bodyguards. Roland. And Asher. And you. Wait a minute. Why is my designated regent Lord Patrick Seagod? It's going to be Rob. And an advisor will be... let's see... The Small John. And we need another advisor. That'll be Theomore, Lord of the Dreadfort. Lord Ofgar Wall died. Let's see. Shall revert to the king? Nope. It shall go to his widow, young Gawain of Gatehouse Tower, Lord Ofgar's ward. No. Let's go to his widow. Some of your kin are unhappy. I don't give a damn. I don't give a damn. We're doing more important things. Ah, the Vale went through the mountains to try to get around the northern armies. It will be their undoing. Actually, it may very well be ours, because if they take the neck, then we won't be able to resupply our men down south. Alright. It's warming as winter comes to an end in Mokalen. Where are the Reach armies at? Oh, I know why these armies are diminishing, because they keep putting them on boats and sending them up to the north. And we have an army of 15,000 Reachmen that are not going to be Oh, there they go. They're going into the Iron Throne. Nice. Nice. And Jaime Lannister's being a little... He's being a... he's getting cold feet. Ah, Master somebody's been captured. Master Jafar. We will mine you for piety. That's what we'll do. We'll be kind and honorable, and we will mine you for piety. I believe there's a battle happening here in the south. They're moving to Rolling Ford. We're gonna wait till their movement gets locked. We are taking attrition. That's a lot of attrition. I don't like that shit. And they want us to wait. See, the 29th, that's 10 days. We can't last. 100% attrition? That's fucking ridiculous. March on them now. They'll probably pull back. Yep, now march on them. We cannot wait to lose 100% of our men. Come on, before the attrition hits, bam! That's what I'm talking about. And even if they reinforce, it's not enough. I will order Lord John. What do I care? Failed to protect me. Yeah, we got more important shit happening right now. You have a new character. If your character dies now, you will play as Lord Eddard of Harrenhal. News from the Battle of Pines and your grace, your son, Lord Robb Stark, has been slain. He was killed in direct combat by the enemy commander, Lady Ermisande Hayford. She was dangerous. She was dangerous, and Lord Robb has fallen. Does that destroy our alliance? Robb Stark has had ice removed from their treasury. Does that remove our alliance with the Reach? It doesn't seem like it does. No, I think the children of the offspring, our grandchildren, they're the ones who will continue on the alliance. Lady Marjorie, my sincerest condolences. She doesn't seem to be widowed by it. We could marry her to him. Yeah, we could. We could marry her to King Eddard. Oh, that's so weird. That's so weird, but I have to do it. We will marry Lady Marjorie. So weird, but we will do it. Let's see if she even accepts. She might not. Okay, fucking battles. I get it. Battles are a thing. We're still getting hit with attrition. Let's head on to King's Landing ASAP. We're not going to fuck around. Are we going to marry her, or what's going on? What's going on here? Marry the king. He's already considering a proposal from us. Okay. Ah, they have taken Greywater Watch. That could be a problem. Let's see, this army now needs a new leader. Rickon, you will take over command. Otto will aid you, and you will also be supported by, Lyle. Or maybe Harold. He's a defensive expert. Who else can we use? Prester's already here. Let's send the small John there, and you will pursue these armies north. Do not let them get a, we can't let them have too many infantry up in the north. That's bad. That's bad news for us. But we will march. Peace be with you. I accept your suggestion that King Eddard and Lady Marjorie get married. So Marjorie is now the queen. Queen of the north. Really, really, really freaky. That's okay. Now we will siege King's Landing. And I'd like to see them stop us. But now we have an army of 15,000 Veilmen coming towards us. Wait, if that's the case, then let's get siege experts in here. Let's not fuck around. I want to get this shit done. We'll put Owen. We need all of our siege experts. Everyone. Everyone. Rickon, you're now in the south too. Do we have anyone else we can make a commander? Okay. Anyone else? Sir Preston Rambleton, he's kind of good. The Small John, Prince Rickon, Otto, Lyle the Strongbore, you kind of suck. I mean, you suck in the friendliest way possible. Harrion. Where's Harrion? Yes, get the siege experts here. Siege experts will siege King's Landing once and for all. And then this army is going to be led by... Let's see. Is there someone who's good in the center? Roland. Do it. Do it well. While it's clearing out a ruined library in Oldstone, some scholars have found some old scrolls that they thought you should see. They speak of the Faith of the Seven. This man's writing is convincing. Do we dare abandon... You know what? Let's not abandon the old gods, because then that means that the Septons can excommunicate us, and that's really annoying. And if Marjorie is going to be of the Faith of the Seven, we should probably have a priest here proselytizing. Proselytizing in Winterfell. There we go. And she is Queen Marjorie of the North. Nice. Swaying Jaime Lannister. Doesn't seem to be doing us all that well. That's fine. Large numbers of the famished defenders of the Red Keep have succumbed to starvation. I think inviting Lord Paramount Jaime to a hunt will sway him. Yeah, let's go on a hunt this time. We can still be friends, I suppose. But once we take King's Landing, it is all over. Ah, he thanked me for the invitation, but told me he cannot arrive. Non-aggression pact, please? No, you son of a bitch. Damn you, House Lannister. Damn you, aid us. At age 11, your granddaughter, Victoria Greyjoy, died under suspicious circumstances. That's not good. Oh, great, with the armies all going north now. But are you... What? What? She's pregnant already? At age 38? Jesus. Wow, the seed is strong. But now the north is overran by Veilmen. This army of 8,000 will not be able to stop them. And they're just going to join forces, too. That's not good. This is not good, ladies and gentlemen. Are there any other men we can raise? 5,000? Ooh, we have another 17? Hold control to avoid raising levies where there are hostile armies. Okay, that didn't do shit. And that didn't really do shit. It only raises about 200. They're going towards Winterfell. Okay, let's go here. Get these men, and that will give us around 9,000. That's not enough to defeat nearly 20,000 Veilmen. And yeah, they're all going north. Okay, well, I mean, we could launch. We could. What was the attrition like? 7%? Oh, he's got into hiding, that son of a bitch. All right, but we're going to take King's Landing here really soon. Really soon. All we have to do is make sure Winterfell does not fall. We could disband our personal levies. We could. And that would make sure Winterfell does not fall. They would need to have 10,000 men to do that. Because right now, I don't see this force of 9,500 being able to stop all of these. Alright, let's head back to the Wolf's Woods, and then we'll retake that. I think they're going back down south. I'm not sure what they're doing. But King's Landing will fall here soon. And with it, we will take the Crown of Winter back. Your grandson, Prince Reynard, is doing great. Excellent. And we have taken the Red Keep. Ooh. Okay. Small John has joined King Aemon, Lord Dickon. Apparently, the Reach is breaking up into war. The Reach is breaking up in support of the king, the actual king. So that's, Your Grace, we are pleased to report the successful siege of Dragongate. King Aemon Baratheon could not be found, however. Good work, Your Grace. Take them all into the dungeons. It wasn't until several weeks after the banquet I heard about it and wondered why I was not invited. Aren't Lord Holland and I friends? Maybe he forgot. Not anymore. We need to talk. Best friends forever. Maybe he forgot. I don't actually care. I don't honestly care. Let us take all of King's Landing. Do it. Clap the High Septon in chains. There we go. And there it is. That's kind of crazy. We've taken all of King's Landing. King Aemon is in hiding somewhere, and... Oh, Jesus Christ. What do we have to do to win? We probably need to send these armies back north. Well, we've already taken the capital. Why don't we just do that? They've all gone north. We've taken the capital. Let's chase them north now. If we chase them north of the neck, we will trap them in the north. Very Tywin Lannister moment. Two people eloped and got married. I accept their marriage. I don't give a shit. Okay. What is this? Kingdom of the Reach. Take that. And we cannot order because we're not the leader of the siege. Give them money. Money, it is their duty. That's a lot of gold they're asking for. But you know what? We got it. We can't afford to stay here. Keep going north. Go north to Wycombe. I don't know what the Tyrells are going to do. They can stay down south if they want to. But we need to go north and end this episode. I mean, this episode's going... It's probably going to be a lot longer than normal because I... Oh, man. During his long period of abandonment, the roads around Old Stones have become virtually unusable. Give the steward money so he can fix them. After many months of rebuilding, the ruins of Old Stones are finally resembling a habitable place once more. Many immigrants have been flocking to this land, which means even a levy can now be supported. It's only a matter of time until the colony is complete. Colony will be removed from Old Stones. Old Stones gets advanced colony. Nice. We are slowly changing Old Stones for the better. And apparently we're now being supported by the Tyrell forces. We didn't need the Lannisters after all. So how many armies does the Iron Throne have left? 28,000, that's still a lot. And 15,000, yeah, the Vale has lost a lot of troops. Let's retake the Wolf's Woods. Alright, we've got a Vale army heading probably towards Winterfell. And they're dropping off more men. Okay. But the main host is returning back north. I wish we had some organizers so we can get there faster. Play around a little bit more with the commanders. Prince Rickon, you're great for sieges. I don't think we'll need you for much longer, though. Do we have anyone who's an organizer? We need speed. Speed. Damn you. Give me speed. Organizers, where are you? Okay, we got Godric Torrent. That's one. Godric of the House Torrent. More organizers. Organizers, where are you? I know I can actually... Oh, Mera. We'll invite her. We'll see if we can actually use her as a commander. I don't know if we will be able to. Sir John Risley. We'll invite you too. And let's invite a fourth one, just in case we can't have a female as a commander. Because sometimes the game has weird rules like that. Organizers. Apparently organizers are really rare. Alright, well that's four. That should give us more than enough speed. Alright, we've got Godric Trent, we have Mera. Alright, to the commanding noble Eddard. Alright, Wycombe has fallen, but we are now on top of them with our armies. Let's go ahead and let's win this battle first before we go and we start changing our commanders around. Alright. Okay, so they're going to come in on top of us. And we have the advantage of hills now. They showed up way too late. Ah. News in the Battle of Wycombe, Your Grace, your courtier Sir Owen has been killed. Oh, poor bastard. That's also not going to be good. News, your bannerman Lord Harry Karstark has been killed in single combat by Lord Loras, the Knight of Flowers. That's really bad for us. We have lost two commanders, and it's Rickon now fighting alone against Lady Irma Sande. Jesus, she almost didn't broke there. That was madness. Absolute madness, but look at that war score. We were so close to winning. A daughter was born to King Eddard the Bold and Queen Marjorie of the North named Eleona. You know he truly is bold. He is truly a bold king. Do we want Alyona Stark? Ah, we'll take it. We'll take it. Why not? What would be a good thing to train her in? Humility, maybe? Is tutored by servants at the court, focusing on service and humility. Or maybe we can teach her duty. Make her conscientious. Yeah, we'll do that. Rickon somehow survived. What a badass. All right, put Roland in charge of the center. Give me a good flanker, Prestier, and we will push on the south. We will not give them a reprieve. Actually, we don't even need to fight anymore. We have won. We have destroyed the armies of the Iron Throne. I didn't know we were going to be able to do that. I thought Wyllys was going to leave us hanging there, and things really did start to turn against us. But that is it, ladies and gentlemen. We have won. Send him terms. Send him terms. What do we get? Transfer the Crown of Winter, Crown of Winter, Crown of Winter. We get 3 copies of the Crown of Winter, and we get prestige. The King Eddard's War to reclaim their ancestral heirloom from King Aemon of the Iron Throne has ended. King Eddard of the North has won. Oh, yes. The war is over, and we at last have the Crown of Winter. A real Crown of Winter, not this fake thing we made up in the past. And then we will disband the armies, we will wait for the war to come to an end. And that, ladies and gentlemen, will be the conclusion of this series. I hope you all enjoyed the series and this episode. If you did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe as always. This has been Crusader Kings 2, The Wolf's Revenge, the series finale. I have been the Golden Joeblivion, and until next time, I will see you all later.